Yeah, Smart Wargames here. First time I will do a book review. Let's call it Smart Books. And the reason is as follows. Weeks ago discovered by accident that there was once a strategy guide released for Combat Mission Barbarossa to Berlin by Mark H. Walker. And yeah, I was curious about the content. I searched a bit around in the internet. It is out of print. And yeah, also when it comes to reviews, not everybody was so impressed by the book. For many it was too basic, not including enough detail. Also when it comes to content, we will talk about this. But I still was curious, not in order to learn tactics or whatever, I just wanted to see what this book contains, because yeah, a strategy guide, I know it for games back in the days when I was young, for games like PlayStation or whatever, when internet was not full blown with information. And sometimes you try to acquire information for video games, cheat codes, tactics, secrets, by buying those strategy guides for, I don't know, Final Fantasy or Command & Conquer, which also contained Easter eggs and some Jimmy's brought to the school, everybody checked for information. It was always exciting. I guess nowadays this strategy guide thing is rather, yeah, print media strategy guide things, I guess, a thing of the past. You might have some nice guides in the Steam section or also in the forums. But I still want to see how it looks, and yeah, I acquired it. I was rather lucky when I got tipped off about this book. I found a US seller which offered the book for a reasonable low price, because if you look around in the internet, there are some individuals trying to sell this book for quite high prices. The shipping was also fine. It took ages until to arrive. It was sent via, I don't know, a mule. But the mule finally arrived. And the book is with me. I was thinking how to do that. I won't become some professional book reviewer or whatever. I don't even know what the standard is. Not even know how you can do a book review when it comes to copyright stuff and whatever. But I was thinking making photos of some of the pages shouldn't be a problem, and so we will check it out, yeah. And yeah, this is quite interesting. A lot of stuff this book is containing is still relevant for modern combat mission games or even for other tactical war games. And yeah, first, I guess that's always a good thing to read the main manuals, the game itself, because it is written for Barbarossa to Berlin, but includes tactics that are relevant for all three and even for the newer ones. And yeah, even the main game came already with a nice manual, which you can find if you buy it on a GOG. It will be supplemented to you in the main game folder or in this Galaxy app or whatever, so download it. It contains nice information and will also, yeah, visualize you the depth of the game, especially with campaigns, mechanics and everything. It was also even a surprise for me when I checked the manual, when I dove deeper into the classic combat mission again. And yeah, this looks not that thick, but it is one of those, you know, back in the days, those many PC games had this big format. Yeah, so it is one of those big ones. It is not like a manual of a DVD box or whatever. This is of those big boxes, so it is quite containing some. Manuals like this are not made nowadays. Don't mistake it with this one here. I don't know, it looks like there was also a Combat Mission magazine. Yeah, I was thinking this guy here, he's ready for serious business, yeah. So yeah, but this is not. So okay, I got this book and we will handle it in I do it live fashion. I made some photos. I didn't read the book entirely, but I skimmed it. And it is enough to make an opinion. Yeah, that is my copy. Not sure what I will do with it. Perhaps I will sell it again. Or donate it to... Not really a collector. I like to experience new stuff. I like to find exotic stuff concerning war games. I also try to dig out exotic war games, as you perhaps know by the, as this channel contains a lot of titles that are rather same for the book, but I don't collect this stuff, so I might give it to somebody that perhaps, I don't know, always had his life wish to find this book. So yeah, that is the top, the front. And that is the back. It looks a bit used. Yeah, there's a used copy I acquired. And looks nice so far. It seems like it was published by the by Battlefront. As is also stated here by the in the page. Yeah. And yeah, 2003. It seems it was released. And here we have a table of content. Yeah, chapter 1 will focus on infantry tactics. Part 2 on armor tactics. Part 3 combined arms. Part 4 is somewhat mixed with information or interviews with veterans in the forums. And also comes with some information about scenario designing. Yeah, and then there's a really big part of further read. A lot of books for you to read containing information on the Eastern Front, on OOBs, TOEs of the involved forces in Barbarossa to Berlin. Especially if you want to design a scenario or dive deeper into at least into a authentic use of your assets. Yeah, it starts with some introduction. Also includes a bit information what combat mission does different or what it makes unique. And then how to use a book again, overview of the chapters. Yeah, I had to use my watch because the book has a quite stiff back, and in order to make proper dual page screenshots, I had to use some sort of weight. And yeah, it starts with some basic information like how to use cover. And it is usually written this black and white style, including some screenshots, which really makes it hard. Yeah, here, that is basically a pocketbook side, and you don't see that much of on the screenshot. Especially here, this second floor troop command. I mean, sure, on the screenshot it is now even smaller, but it's basically almost the size of the book I photographed here. And it is true, that is also what you often read, that stuff is really hard to read. Another thing that is mentioned in some reviews I found is that this book covers information that the manual is already covering. Yeah? For example, that through I don't have the direct comparison, but for example that only infantry and light guns can move through woods. I can imagine that this is already covered by the manual, but I get it. It is for who is, a strategy guide. It's difficult for who you want to write it. I guess most people interested in something like this would be people that buy combat mission because they're interested, but they perhaps don't know every tank by heart. They don't know the ranges by heart, which we seasoned war gamers acquire by either real world experience and or by playing video games or some grognets by simply reading it up every day. Yeah? And there are people that want to play realistic games, want to experience it, but they perhaps don't know everything And sure, you need to, of course, take them somewhere. If you say, okay, read the manual, and then you should know the manual by heart. Now read my hardcore strategy guide. Yeah, no, and you immediately go into the detailed stuff. Sure, the Grognard, yeah, that already plays, I don't know, 2-3 years combat mission, and beforehand played Steel Panthers 10 years, or see, I don't know, it was 10 years ago, around, let's say 5 years. Yeah, and then he played, I don't know, Tigers on the Prowl, and he hits the book. Sure, you know, those guys are never satisfied, those, they always know better. And it is also the question, if somebody like this, he would buy a book, those guys might be rather very invested into some forums where they talk every day, accumulate thousands of posts in what is those tactics and this tactics. I think that's really hard to write a book for those guys. Yeah, I guess a strategy guide, that is also basically for most games, a strategy guide would rather, you know, if you read a strategy guide about Command & Conquer, it doesn't mean that you will hit the first place in the golden, the first place in a Veterans Command Conquer PvP tournament. Yeah, but exactly. What I like here is, but that is not of, is that you're also given examples, because that is often, I think also when it comes to the tactical level, it's really hard to find how to do something. Yeah? People say, yeah, you need to use cover. Yeah, you need to use this. Always keep a reserve attack with. But how to do it? Yeah, how. What does are the steps I need to do? And at least here you are given two examples how you can hold an objective against an enemy attack. It also stresses the fact that reserve slope defense in combat mission is quite effective. That is already good. And I think I also saw here, well, what it might be on a different page. Yeah, one interesting thing I saw here is also it talks about leadership and might also talk about some values. I'm not sure if this are in the main manual. How much fatigue they take. Yeah? Interesting is that sneak is basically the, I think, the low crawl move, or it is at least a simulation of very cautious move, is in modern combat mission. Because modern combat mission perceives this as a crawl. A crawl is indeed in the military one of the most demanding, physically demanding movement types. If you're not trained to it, you will crawl a couple of meters, you will be absolutely wasted. I think it is also a really good full body training. If you want to get ripped, crawl everywhere. Crawl into the kitchen, crawl into the bed, crawl to the supermarket. While not being seen, crawl through the supermarket products. And you will notice a lot of people are surprised because they never crawl in their life. It's not often crawl needed, but if you do, I don't know, 50 meters while not trained, while not conditioned. But here it is different. I think, I'm not exactly sure, but sneak was crawling in this game. There's no slow or no crawl in classic combination. There's some differences between the three titles, but interesting. Yeah? So they changed it here. And what I like is that move to contact, I mean, move to contact is basically stop on contact or whatever. That is, I don't understand why they did that. Yeah, that this in modern combat mission, but yeah, that is another story, that in modern combat mission is having quite a fatigue. I guess it is somewhat representing advance, but it is different. Yeah, some of this stuff is even better in the classic, I think, but that is a different story. We are reviewing here the book, and yeah, a lot of you will find, of course, the orders they highlight in bold are made for Combat Mission 1, but I think most stuff you will read here, with some exceptions, are also would be good for a game like Modern Combat Mission, or even for games like, I don't know, Steel Panther based games like WinSP World War II, or Steel Panthers itself. Yeah, it talks about headquarters, because there are some special rules in place. I say some come with bonuses. It's also interesting, I think that is not shown in the game or in the, that how fast squads will respond. But that is also questionable because the response time is also, it comes also down to how complex your order is. But it's so interesting that I think that is of that, that is notorious. Combat Mission is notorious for, I guess it is also deliberately, that is also the truth for modern Combat Mission, that it tells you about the basics, but a lot of stuff is not explained. I mean, I like it to some extent because it keeps the magic. I don't want to know every single value. I sometimes even play assuming some stuff is in place and perhaps it is not even in place, but I do it for immersion and for my own playing pleasure. But it also comes with certain problems that perhaps beginners want to find out about something like C2, go to the forums, post a question or whatever, and get 10 different answers, yeah, because some people, they always like to answer, they like to explain, but are not really good at checking if they are really telling the facts. But we will talk about this later. Okay, then there's a chapter 3, which is... yeah, about, I guess, defense. And, for example, some aspects, especially if you take it, compare it then to later aspects, like those tables there that are of questionable worth. There's something like machine guns are covered in a rather short... because this book is built, basically, you have those brackets of information. I'm also not sure. I get it. You want to make it exciting for read. Yeah, machine gunners, harbingers of death. So what is it now focusing on? How to position my machine guns? The firepower advantage. I mean this one is named properly, but there's something, some stuff like yeah, the Reich leader for the Reich. Okay, it still makes sense. But sometimes those titles are rather. Use a wording that is more in order to make it more exciting, more to oh, what is now coming. But I guess if you use this book as some sort of, okay, quickly looking for some information about combat and morale or whatever, it might be better to maintain clear titles in order to quickly identify. This goddamn Windows thing here. Okay, yeah, it's talking about firepower, fire superiority, probably one of the most important things. Covered arcs, still relevant to the modern, the fuse of flanks. And yeah, now we come to an aspect of the book that is also often mentioned to be what we would call it paper filler. It comes with a lot of pages of infantry OOBs, which give you an overview of what weapon composition those squads have and what they cost, or what is it, penetration, what is this, total FP, 1000 meters, whatever. It is basically, this information is given by you in the game. If you start the game, I think it's, and you press enter, you will be given the information. So the question is now, sure, you could say, yes, sometimes if you have no clue about infantry, and as I mentioned, you might play this game and you don't know what is the finish coming up with, not sure how this would help me. I have now, first I would have need to identify which squad I'm running, then would realize, okay, those guys are fast, great, and they carry, okay. Then I have what? Oh no, wait, I'm in 43 or I'm in 41. I can simply press enter and get the information in 1 second. So, I mean, the critique that this is just paper filler, yeah, it is definitely valid, yeah, to some extent. I think if this would be modern combat mission, I mean, modern combat mission, you also have the information in the below UI. If this would be information not presented to you in the game, then it might be a different story. For example, we will come to something that unfortunately was dropped in Modern Combat Mission. There is a mod that tries to even it out. That is perhaps for a beginner sometimes challenging, especially if he doesn't know every tank and and Tankletality by heart. Yeah, okay, there's some and that is, I must skip the entire armor aspect. It's about how to use armor, what is armor good for, how important it is that you keep your armor with infantry. They stress it out, that is good, because Combat Mission is one of those few games that is not tank porn. I think a lot of tactical games is absolute tank dominant, and there are some few games that are not. I think Combat Mission is among them. If you will leave your tanks alone, either they are not even able to capture certain objectives because it is simply no tank country, or B, they will blow up. And this is also stressed here, this combined arms aspect, and also how to do reconnaissance with vehicles and everything in case you need to do that. Yeah, exactly. Now we come to this here. Oh, okay. Archmy. Yeah. Yeah, so next we have again a lot of tables with a ton of pages, because you can imagine how many vehicles are in Classic Combat Mission in Barbarossa, as it is depicting the entire Eastern Front early, even including the Finnish Winter War, I think, up to, yeah, Berlin. So there's a ton of vehicles, yeah, and it is great, you will give some information, but as I mentioned, everything is visible in-game by hitting the enter button. So the question is, what is faster? If you, even if you have no idea of tanks, yeah, you don't know Joseph Stalin 1, what can a Joseph Stalin 1 do against Homan and okay, it can penetrate 128 mm. The Tiger head, oh wait, I need to check the 6 pages I had. While in the game you press enter on this unit, then you press enter on this unit, you let the numbers crunch in your head and you're done. And you check at first what is the range of a certain gun, penetration range, or here, you, let's say this Joseph Stalin 2 faces a Tiger at 500 meters or 1000 meters, and you check the third number in-game, you realize, okay, it can penetrate up to 104 millimeters, yeah, and the Tiger doesn't have that much. So a nice clean shot might do the pen. And in game you simply hit twice enter, I think. I'm not exactly sure if you can do it on enemy units. That of course would then give this at least some need for existence. But I think you can do. You can hit the get this information on every unit that is presented to you. Yeah, so for Combat Mission 2 on the other hand, because, unfortunately, for Combat Mission 2, this enter button was dropped. And you have some bars and whatever, but they give you little information. So in Combat Mission 2, something like this is quite helpful, because it gives you, if you have absolutely no idea of vehicles, like, that you simply don't know by heart that a Sherman 75er has almost no chance against a Panther Frontal, but a Sherman 76er might blow up the Panther, and the stuff you play those games for some time, it simply will burn into your brain. But if you start out new and there's a lot of vehicles in World War II, for example, I'm here, those BTs, I use them so seldom in games, and yeah, so I might check the data in by pressing enter, or I would have a table like this, you might check it out. So yeah, there's a lot of pages with this, I guess, for all vehicles that were by standard in the game. So it is filling the book also, yeah, quite. And I will show you the book is not so thick, if you keep its format in mind. Okay, as I mentioned, this will now talk about combined arms, which is very important in Combat Mission. It is not a tank pawn show, it is not a mow down the infantry show. Infantry also is very capable and if put into right positions, and this will stress this out. And I think I've read it, perhaps you already skipped the page, it also some really important tactics that are perhaps not really visible by the manual, not visualized, is that, was it here somewhere? Or perhaps you already skipped it. That urban warfare in combat mission or urban terrain in combat mission, that is also true for modern combat mission, is rather not too detailed simulated. Yeah. So usually a building with an interior, or a building offers an interior which might be spotted or not spotted, and that's it. Yeah. And for example, units that sit on the outside of villages, if they are spotted by vehicles, they might get simply blown up. Yeah, this classic combat mission, some chimney fires from a window, is spotted by a tank or IFV, the IFV blows him up. A real urban combat, no matter if World War II or modern, is a bit more complex. Yeah. It can even sometimes take hours. And that's also, I think it was in the scenario section, yeah. Why they sometimes use some tricks or make it harder in order to defy this somewhat simplistic urban combat system of combat mission. Because if you keep all buildings simply in the open, they will be spotted by vehicles sooner or later and get flushed out. Well, this is not true for real situations often. Yeah, what I like about this here is that could be more. Unfortunately, that is only covering 5-6 pages. The author did 2-3 or 5 or whatever scenarios. Skip one page. Yeah, okay, whatever happens. Because I deleted it. However, there is a section that focuses on certain of the original scenarios and helps you to play with them, yeah, how to position it. And it's not like those after-action reports, which sometimes feel, some of them feel like the opposite, the other way around, yeah, somebody achieves something and then he, look how I achieved it, yeah. Here it is, you have a situation, how to analyze it and what could possibly happen, how to position it, how to position your units, what do you want to expect, you know, from the start, yeah, not retrospective. Yeah, oh, here I did a really great job with my assault. Yeah, that was really genius for me. But analyzing the situation, you don't even know what is coming up. But it's also rather short. Yeah, it's not including much. It talks a bit about setup, but for example here, that is sentences. Sorry, that there's no perfect setup for the scenario. What is important that you study the terrain, employ your weapons wisely, and keep a reserve. Wow, okay, yeah, that is of course wisdom of the day. Yeah, that is exactly what I mean. You often hear it also in YouTube videos, this infantry tactics or whatever, World War II or whatever, a company was always considered, or a battalion was considered to keep a reserve. Yeah, how did this reserve look like? Yeah, when was it deployed? Where was it kept? Detailed information, I guess, that really are important for combat mission players or for new players. Yeah, keep a reserve. How is the reserve looking? Employ your weapons wisely. Yeah, I think that is employ your weapons wisely. Yeah, you could write this on the fridge. It would be always true. Yeah, you should always employ your weapons wisely. I think there's no scenario where you need to deploy your weapons unwisely. But how you do it is, of course, a bit. I mean, I guess it was beforehand, perhaps a bit more detailed. I'm missing here one page I wanted to show, but still, that is not a setup recommendation. That is rather like, yeah, Jimmy. Karl Müller, how should I deploy my units wisely? Ah, okay, yeah, true. Forgot about that, thanks. I mean, there is some information then given, but I think aspects like this could be more detailed. But it's okay. I mean, stuff like this you also find perhaps in the internet. Yeah. And then there's this one of the last chapters is about talking with veterans, which will be handed a set of questions. Hey, what really wondered me is here, do you feel the difference between Combat Mission Beyond Overlord and Barbarossa to Berlin? Yes. Combat Mission Barbarossa to Berlin has been tweaked for even more realism than CMBO, certain gamey tactics no longer work so well. For example, sending a bunch of infantry over open ground will get you in trouble if the enemy has a machine gun covering that area. Last time when I played Covert Mission Beyond Overlord and I sent some infantry towards a machine gun over open terrain, those guys wouldn't arrive. I don't know, perhaps on release CMBO was a different game. Perhaps they patched a lot of the realism into CMBO after it was already after the other games released. I don't know about the history of those games, but it's interesting because I never would do in Beyond Overlord either. Never heard that this will work out good. But there's some interesting information, yeah, about reserve slope, which I mentioned plays an important role even to this very day in combat mission, especially in multiplayer. Reverse slope, not reserve. And also how to spend 1000 points for quick battle meetings, as many people like to play quick battles in multiplayer against AI, so this can also be a nice one if you want to get some information about what to use. Yeah, that is true. And what is the best tank platoon? Okay, and as I mentioned, this will now follow with a lot of pages where people are asked. People that I guess already have, many of them are scenario designers. So they already have something in mind when designing the scenarios. And I guess they're also avid combat mission players, or were avid combat mission players. And it is basically as a collection like you sometimes have out of a forum. You might find information like this also in Modern Combat Mission Forum or whatever. The problem is if you don't know about the details, about truth, and simply telling crap rather than talking rather than chew, which some should do sometimes, it is difficult for you to find out what is good, what is bad. Yeah, it's what often happens. Somebody asks a question, you get 10 different answers, and every answer, every post indicates as if it would be a fact. Why often, it doesn't matter if somebody has 1000 posts, some people are really notorious and not checking what they're posting. And so it is a good idea that somebody with a high standard of information gathering, somebody that has a high standard that makes first sure that whatever he gathers there, there are really nice forum threads with really good information about stuff like C2, tank assaults, whatever. But you often you need to swift through that. There's a lot of crap posted into that. And if you don't know simply about the what is right, what is wrong, you can't tell. You might even follow the wrong one because perhaps it's a guy that has more posts. But a guy that has only, I don't know, 10 posts made the best, but you can't tell. So that would be something good, if even nice one for a CM2. I think a strategy guide, a modern combat mission strategy guide, where somebody one collects the best information, true information. I'm not talking about information he said, she said, but stuff like C2. There was a nice thread, for example, where somebody simply miraculously researched how to, or IEDs is also often a thing. How to use IEDs in Shock Force. That people, even to this very day, how I defuse an IED, how I defuse a mine, why I'm blowing up when I'm doing this and that. And there was one thread because I think the manual, I don't know, I didn't check it for a long time, isn't covering it. But if you ask about IEDs, you also get sometimes answers that are simply not true. Yeah. And somebody might follow them and then goes into the game, spends 3 hours trying to defuse. Tries to defuse an anti-tank mine and wonders why that is not possible when he drives over a vehicle over it and the vehicle still blows up and he wonders what is wrong and tries it even further, wastes more hours, gets frustration and then points at the game is bad. And yeah, so something like this, especially for some aspects of the game, or C2, how is C2 working? So also often ask, how is this working? And there was one post that basically summed everything up for all combat mission games, even the distance was measured out. That is a guy that you can immediately tell he first makes sure that whatever he claims is tested properly. He's like a scientist Many are unfortunately not. Many are saying, it's green. How do you know? I don't... was thinking. And yeah, but unfortunately those posts get buried fast by... and this would be definitely something great if you, if somebody would take the best information out of all those forums and whatever and write some sort of a Steam guide, I guess written, you won't, but I would buy it. I mean, don't need it, I guess, anymore, but new players would be definitely interesting, because I can imagine that is a challenge sometimes to swim through this. Many posts are also not train wrecked, off topic, derailed, into whatever talk, who was stronger, Germany 41 or Soviets 43. Okay, but this is nice one here. Not sure, I didn't read it all, but just to get some idea. Good, and then there's a scenario design. Here's even Sea Pandas mentioned. And you can, because somebody said that the author of the book, it feels like he has no clue of combat mission. It can happen, sometimes people might be recruited to write a book and they just inform artificially about a topic and then they write an expert opinion or whatever about it. Happens, yeah. Happens also in other areas. I think documentaries are sometimes quite notorious for that. You can immediately tell that the journalists or whatever responsible for that really didn't dive too much into the topic they are covering and they somehow feel clueless. But here, I don't think that is true. I read some of the stuff and I think the author who wrote this is also an avid combat mission player. You can simply tell by wording. And yeah. Here, open villages and towns. Yeah, here's some deadly sense of map making. And a village and a town might look like on the photographs or on the maps you see, but might not translate too good in the combat mission. I think that's a good tip. Because combat mission simply depicts, yeah, if those guys are sitting in the building, they might get spotted and simply blown out. While in real, a tank cannot always make sure that everybody in a building is. Yeah, those buildings also have basements, cellars and whatever. That is, for example, in combination not depicted. You can't hide in a cellar, while in reality you might. And then a tank can do nothing against you. Or little. And that's also what you should, of course, keep in mind when designing scenarios. If you go one-to-one and you set those chimneys in the buildings, in reality it was a really bloody fight, and in combat mission you might, with tank support, flush them out in a couple of minutes. And then there's a do and don'ts about the scenario editing. I mean, why not? This could be still relevant for today. And then there's a lot of this additional information. Nowadays, I guess you can look up everything on the internet, but you need to take into account 2003. There were not millions of internet historians running around, grognards that will tell you everything. Knowledge was still somewhat limited. Stuff like Wikipedia or other online information databases were rather, in the beginning. And I think it's a good thing, yeah, to read the stuff here. For example, we will see, some pretty popular titles, especially when it comes to Eastern Front, like Glantz, those classic authors. And it also comes with a little description. There's a lot of those pages. You only see one here. I made pictures of there's 10 or whatever. So it is pretty good. And in order to read for your mission designs, campaigns, to get some background, also about the tactics. Yeah. Some of those field manual style informations at least can give you a hint on how they would have deployed and whatever. There is something I think is missing, but that is obvious. What I would sometimes really enjoy in modern combat mission or in classic combat mission, I don't care, is the application of real authentic tactics. I don't even care that much for my results there. It's not really defining me. I rather define myself by my real life achievements. I rather play for the experience. And sometimes I would like to use, even if it's perhaps not translating into combat mission too well, as combat mission and the reality of tactical World War II or modern warfare is still, there's still a difference, still a discrepancy. But I saw some, there's some interesting training videos on YouTube, for example, where German instructional videos or US instructional videos on how to use a platoon, shoot those basics like two squads, fix one squad is maneuvering and flanking and finishing it, whatever, you know, those Fs of find, fix, flank, etc. And but there's also some interesting tactics like Panzer Grenadiers, how they counterattack when the enemy is breaching the defense, and there's really some quite detailed tactics how to use even how they use a mechanized response force. And yeah, so if you sometimes I think it's hard to find good information how something was done step by step. Yeah. How real commanders set up good defenses. You sometimes read combat accounts and you need to extract the information out of the combat accounts, like why if you read of the combat account of some captain or whatever, and then he tells, okay, I positioned my machine guns here, I positioned my this unit there. And sometimes they really have unique layouts and you think, okay, interesting, would like to know how they came to this conclusion in order to use this defense. Is this something they really learned by in officer training school? A lot of the military information is also given is given from instructors or other officers or to aspirants. And what you see in field manuals is of course really good, because there's a lot of video footage focusing on those field manuals. I think it's in the modern military the same. It is giving you good ideas. Doesn't mean you need to use it as if it is written in stone, that some people don't understand. It is a guide. But the reality might look entirely different. And information like this, a book, I don't know. I was thinking about doing a video series where we might do that, where we analyze some instructional videos about rather complex tactics. I'm not really interested in the basics, yeah. The squad in a firefight and everything, there's also a ton of videos around about this. But rather some crazy tactics like this mechanized infantry video I saw there. Wonder how this would work in a combat mission, multiplayer or single player environment. Yeah, but so information like this would be great. That is often hard to find. Everything is so is hitting the surface, but in detail, what you need to do a defense here and there, captain, explain me step by step what you're doing with all your units, yeah, in World War II. But here, squad tactics in World War II, so it would be a good read. Yeah, that is the thickness of the book. It is not much, and as I mentioned, if you take into account that there are minimum 20 pages or whatever, filled by, I don't know exactly, what was the amount of pages? Yeah, you can look it up online, yeah. It is listed on Amazon, there should be a page amount. But it's not really a super thick book. And I guess it's something you could read really in a short amount of time. And yeah. So I wanted to check it out, and I think for the audience, it is written, it is basically a manual 2.0. It's an expanded manual offering you more directions, yeah, because otherwise a normal manual would become too thick, too expensive, or too big. And that is basically also what most gaming strategy guides back then were. Yeah, there were not some hardcore tactics for some grognards that play already 10 years and look for the super secret. That something like this simply didn't exist, and like this knowledge, and you would be also. So I think nowadays, sure, it's not really need anymore, especially with those many platforms we have, like Steam Guides and several gaming forums, YouTube, of course, as well, in order to watch. There's countless tutorials on YouTube for many battle war games. But yeah, as mentioned back in the days, this was not common, and there was still some print media that, and I think it did, I don't know from how much it sold back in the days, but I don't think they sold it for a fortune. So I think it's okay, yeah. Good, yeah, that was my first book review, if you want to call it like that. But yeah, to preserve it for history, in general, I like the idea that they made books for something like this. I think the other one I know only is, and it is even still accessible through archive, Close Combat, The Russian Front. Also saw a strategy guide. It is even liked. Was well received. I don't know how complex it was. But yeah, if you want to see another video like this, perhaps even for this Close Combat Strategy Guide, as Close Combat is also shares some similarities with Combat Mission. Both games apply similar ideas, similar philosophies. And other than that, see you in the next episode. Good hunting.